Thinking about jumping into Final Fantasy XIV for the first time but have no idea what's going on? We've got you covered. Here's the entire Final Fantasy XIV story so far, which encompasses one complete overhaul, three expansions, and a whole lot of crystals. For the purpose of this video, we're going to skip over Final Fantasy XIV's false start and head straight into A Realm Reborn, the revised version of the game headed up by Naoki Yoshida. Let's begin. You start Final Fantasy XIV as an adventurer off to explore the land of Eorzea 5 years after the calamity that summoned the deity Bahamut and nearly destroyed the land. After helping with odd jobs and taking down some criminals, you awaken to the power of the Echo, making you a chosen one of the goddess Hydaelyn. With the Echo, you're able to see into the past as well as gain immunity to tempering, essentially brainwashing at the hands of summoned primal beasts, which is currently the main problem that Eorzea has to deal with. Because of this special power, you're recruited by a heroic group called the Scions of the Seventh Dawn, led by a character named Minfilia, whose goal is to protect Eorzea from the primal threat. On your adventures, you'll also meet Alphanode and Alice Levelier, who will be constant companions throughout the series. Things in Eorzea eventually come to a head as the Garlean Empire, an evil country bent on bringing the world under their rule, appears and uses the biotechnological Ultima weapon to absorb the power of the primals. You have to defeat not only the Ultima weapon and the Empire, but also Lahabria, a powerful Ascian who has been helping the Empire behind the scenes. The Ascians are the sworn enemies of the Hydaelyn, and they intend to revive their dark god Zodiark. They're basically a boomer cult longing for the good old days. But despite the odds, you take them all down, save Eorzea, and are declared the Warrior of Light. Good for you! After the Ultima weapon is defeated, civil unrest slowly comes to a boiling point in the city-state of Ulda, while the Scions deal with continual primal threats around Eorzea. Alphanode decides to create his own military force, called the Crystal Braves, to help combat the threats. It goes about as well as you'd expect a military group led by a young idealistic man to go, which is to say badly. Corruption quickly spreads within Ulda and the Crystal Braves, and the Sultana of Ulda is assassinated during a celebratory banquet. The murder is pinned on the Scions, and they're forced to escape the city, but with heavy losses. With only the Warrior of Light and Alphanode remaining, the Scions seek revenge in Ishgard, a snowy city-state typically closed off to outsiders, officially kicking off the events of Final Fantasy XIV's first expansion, Heavenswards. Thanks to the assistance of ally and all-around great guy Orshifant, the Warrior of Light is able to find refuge in Ishgard. But as it goes with heroes, it doesn't take long for the Scions to become embroiled in Ishgard's political issues and their war with the dragons, the Dragonsong War. It's soon revealed that this classist, religiously ran city-state was built on a pile of lies and that humans betrayed the dragons, causing the Dragonsong War in the first place. You lose Orshifant, take down the corrupt leader of Ishgard, and the most elite of the Ishgardian knights, Heavenswards, opening Ishgard's eyes to a more peaceful future.
For the future of Eorzea.
For the future of Eorzea!
There were Ascians involved again as well. Don't worry, you killed them. Also, the Sultana is fine. She only faked her death at the banquet, so no hard feelings. With the truth about the Dragonsong War revealed, Ishgard works to make a lasting peace with the dragons, with the previous Ishgardian leader's son, Amarek, leading the talks. However, there is reluctance on both sides to put their hatred aside after centuries of violence. Tensions reach a breaking point when the dread worm Nidhogg, the revenge-crazed dragon that declared war on humans long ago, is revived. With no small amount of effort, the Warrior of Light defeats Nidhogg and opens the way for Emmerich to finally open the path to peace. But there isn't just trouble in Ishgard, as the Warriors of Darkness appear in Eorzea, hellbent on killing the Warrior of Light. The Warriors of Darkness are the obvious counters to the Warrior of Light and came from another dimension where their world is overwhelmed with the power of light that threatens to destroy it with a flood of ethereal energy. Minfilia, who was originally lost during the frantic escapes from Ulda, returns as an envoy of Hydaelyn and goes with the Warriors of Darkness to stop the flood.
Minfilia.
There's no time to ponder more about the Warriors of Darkness either, as a revolutionary group seeks to free the Eorzean city-estate of Alamigo from Garlean rule. Frustrated with the Eorzean alliance's inaction, they dress up as alliance military and attack the Garleans directly, forcing both sides' hands. During this battle, one of the Scions dies, another isn't who she seems to be, and Final Fantasy's next expansion, Stormblood, officially begins. With Eorzea now embroiled with the Garlean Empire in a war for Alamigo, the forces led by Rauban, the right hand of the Sultana of Ulda, and Lys, one of the Scions who was born in Alamigo, attempt to push forward and retake the country. However, they're met with a downtrodden population and a devastating defeat at the hands of Xenos, son of the Garlean Empire and an all-around not great guy. The Scions surmise that if they're able to liberate another part of the world under Garlean rule, they'll be able to raise morale. So they head to the faraway land of Doma, find and convince the son of the former Doman Lord Hyan to take back the throne and overthrow the Garlean presence in the area. You return to Alamigo, and as word of the successful campaign at Doma reaches the Eorzean army, morale is raised and they begin retaking the country. After a supposedly final battle with Xenos, the Warrior of Light wins the day and frees the country from its chains. As Doma and Alamigo work to rebuild, a startling discovery is made. Xenos is alive after all, miraculously surviving, slicing his own neck open. Impressive. As the Eorzean Alliance tries to prepare for the Garlean's renewed assault on the land, the Scions begin mysteriously falling into comas after hearing a voice of unknown origin. The remaining Scions learn that those who fall into a coma have had their souls taken to another dimension. Meanwhile, the voice continues to plague the Scions and the Warrior of Light even on the battlefield, causing distractions and headaches in an almost deadly encounter with the reanimated Xenos. Becoming more present in the Warrior of Light's mind, the mysterious voice explains that this fight won't matter, as another calamity is coming if the Warrior of Light doesn't come to their dimension and save them, which is kicking off Shadowbringers, the latest expansion. Warrior of Light travels to the First, an alternate dimension where the world was almost destroyed 100 years ago from an overabundance of light. The Crystal Exarch, a powerful yet enigmatic mage who summoned you and the Scions to this dimension, explains that while the Flood was stopped by the Warriors of Darkness 100 years ago, the First is still on the verge of destruction. If the First is swallowed by the light, this will cause another calamity in the Scion's home dimension, so it must be stopped. The Crystal Exarch would prefer his own world not get destroyed too, so it's a win-win for everyone, really. To save the First, the Warrior of Light must become the Warrior of Darkness and bring darkness back to the world, literally and figuratively, to rebalance the ethereal scales. You're also hunted by the ghost of the leader of the Warriors of Darkness, Ardbert. It happens.
What? Did you just... You can hear me?
Along the way, the Scions are repeatedly visited by Emmett Selk, one of the most powerful Ascians and general orchestrators behind many of the series' conflicts. He implies that the battle between good and evil isn't all as it seems, and the Ascians are trying to return the world to its original whole form. You, as the Warrior of Darkness, eventually bring the Night back to the First, but in doing so, threaten to become a monstrous Sin Eater yourself. The Crystal Exarch tries to fix this, but Emmett Selk stops him, leaving the Warrior of Darkness, that's you, in a dangerous position. Eventually though, Ardbert's ghost saves the Warrior of Darkness, and they're able to defeat Emmett Selk and bring the Night Sky back to the First.
Remember that we once lived.
Congratulations, you're now caught up on the main story beats of Final Fantasy XIV. It's an MMO, so the plot of this long-running RPG is ever-changing, and there are plenty of side stories and crossover content to discover, but now you're caught up on the plot, and you'll be mostly ready for Endwalker's release later this year. Now, I have a near raid to get to, whatever that means. For plenty more Final Fantasy XIV, XV, XVI, and whatever they make after that content, you're already in the right place, IGN.